the bike is classified as a sport touring machine, but that really shouldn't be confused as being a sport bike. It's sporty within its very reasonable limitations, but it is not a sport bike. This is a big, heavy machine, which is a very capable handler, but these are sport bikes, and they handle like sport bikes. I'll start here in the cockpit, and I guess I'll just go through things. I guess I'll start right here. So this button, above high low beam, obviously, turn signals, horn, four-way flash here, windshield up and down. Now turn the bike on so you can see. That works pretty self-explanatory. Over here we have a switch that will adjust the angle of the low beam. It does nothing to the high beam, but you can put the low beam closer in front of you or point it more upright. In fact, I know from taking this out last night, I had it on its highest position, and car drivers were flashing me because apparently it must have been too high for their eye. So I lowered it a little bit, and that solved that issue. The headlights are very good in general, especially on high beam. And you'll see pictures of the nose later on in this video. So this bike has a 12 volt outlet that the previous owner installed. He also, I don't know if this is a two owner bike as I understand it, well, three owner now. One of the previous owners, not me, installed this riser, and I think it adds probably 3/4 of an inch. I'm not sure, I haven't really dug into it too much. He did have the mounting balls for a Garmin, and they came with the bike. I've taken them off. I haven't cleaned this up yet. The dash is the dash. Some people like it, some people don't. I don't mind it. I haven't gone through all of these functions yet, but this is a rubberized button for weather protection, I would assume. I like analog dials. You know what? If it's a motorcycle, I pretty much like it, so I really don't care what's on the dash. This is very easy to read. The only difficult thing on the dash to read is over here, which is your information center, if you will, which I rarely use. I'm obviously going to be concerned with my coolant temperature, but it does give you. I don't know if that will show up. It does give you ambient temperature. So right now, I believe if I can get that, you'll see it's showing 14 degrees Celsius. Hopefully that showed up well enough to read it. And as you can see, the mileage or the kilometers on this bike is 39,000. I'll put that back on. Fuel at the top. And just above this 14 degrees, this is your coolant bar. So it doesn't give you an actual readout like some of my other Hondas. It just has a bar that goes across. So if you're in the center range, you should be fine. pardon me. This bike does have speakers installed, and the previous owner did install some sort of a radio / MP3 player that he housed here in this little glove box, and you can see some of the wires are still left. I've taken that out because I couldn't get it working. And speaking of the glove box, you've got some reasonable room in there. Both sides, so there's a left and a right glove box, they get very warm. So if you stop at a store for a cold drink and put it in either one of these little cases, it will not stay cold very long. And there we go. My garage door opener, which I just Velcroed onto this. I didn't mention it because it's pretty self-explanatory, but this is your brake fluid reservoir, and this is your clutch. So the bike does have a hydraulic clutch. Clutch works excellent. I was surprised when I rode it for the first time how quickly it engaged, but it's just a matter of getting used to it. Every machine that you ride will have different idiosyncrasies, and you get used to them very quickly. Of course, your run button, starter. Now, this is nice. I had one of these, or a very similar device, on my Blackbird, but this one works far better. So this is a throttle lock, and I'll just lock that in place. It does a really good job of actually holding the throttle in place, and that gives you some relief on your wrist. It disengages if the brake is applied, or if you, I'll do that again, if you just tap this little button here, it will release the throttle. Really, really works well. I think that's about it in terms of the cockpit. Okay, well, I forgot the mirrors. I'm still here on the bike. The mirrors are great. No vibration. Very easy to just to glance down. I have no problem with the mirrors at all. In fact, I will say that they are the best mirrors that I have ever had on any bike. And I am 54 now, and I started riding when I was 14. I have had probably, if I added them all up, 15 or 16 bikes. So I've seen many, many, many mirrors. These ones are great. You should have no complaints with the mirrors on this bike. And they are adjustable, of course. You just push on the mirror itself and adjust it to the position that you want. Oh, the grips. Standard Honda grips. I love these grips. They're just soft and pliable, very comfortable. I have ordered heat tape so that I can install or have heated grips. I had the same heat tape on my Blackbird, and it made riding much more comfortable, especially if you get older. You know, us old guys and gals, we start appreciating things like heat, and I always ride with a heated vest.